Good afternoon. The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection. Our time for reflection leader today is the Reverend James Bogue, the Minister of Broome Parish Church of Scotland, Newton Mearns.
Presiding Officer, members of the Scottish Parliament, thank you for this opportunity to address you this afternoon. It's quite common nowadays when driving into a town to notice that it's been twinned with another town or city in another country. And I've often wondered how this has come about. What do the towns have in common? Are they similar in size, population, or whatever? In the church, some of our congregations are twinned with other congregations overseas or nearer to home. Not that the congregations are necessarily similar in any way, but perhaps twinned more by way of sharing experiences or perhaps assistance. It may be financial, material, or personnel. It's a two-way exchange, as each can share what the other has. My own congregation has recently become involved in twinning, but not with another town or congregation, but twinning toilets. When it was suggested that we might consider this, it was done so rather hesitantly. We wondered how it would be viewed. Would it be taken seriously? Was it a ridiculous idea? Well, it has, and it isn't. And I'm very pleased to say that the idea has been embraced and supported heartily by our congregation and indeed others. It's very humbling to be made aware of the dreadful and sanitary conditions that some people have to use, or more accurately, have to endure. Each week, we are asked to spend a penny. In other words, to drop our small change into a modified toilet bowl. For every £60 or £240 raised, this will provide one single toilet unit or a complete toilet block for a school or community, maybe in Chad, India, Pakistan, or Uganda. We are all aware that poor sanitation leads to disease and death, and in this toilet twinning project, we are helping with our small change. We are helping vulnerable people at the most basic level. I can still remember very well indeed the outside toilet that we shared with the entire close where I lived as a boy in Port Glasgow, and that was over 50 years ago. What we had then was far, far better than some people have today. In the cut and thrust of politics, industry and commerce, it's easy to forget or perhaps overlook the most basic of human needs. May I humbly suggest that the next time you notice a town twinned with another, that you pause and think of something much more basic, and to note that even our small change can make a big change.
Thank you. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 12487 in the name of Joe Fitzpatrick.